You really gonna make me expose you for exactly what you are. You are. I'm feeling kind of wavy. So right now I don't mind pulling your card. And as hard as you try to hide reality, what we know the truth. So act brand new if you want to. Where would you be without me? What would you be without me? So what you blowing up? Just a little. They knowing you a little. Get the finger in the middle. Cause little nigga, you would never be without me. What would you be without me? So what you blowing up? Just a little. They knowing you a little. Get the finger in the middle. Cause little nigga, you would never be. Oh, nah, no, nah, 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 nah. Oh, nah, nah. Na na, oh na na, oh na.
Hi Facebook fam, it's your girl Mel, and it's that time again, transition transformation time for me. 2014 nail cutting ceremony. Yep, I said it, there it is. I'm cutting them all off. Okay, last time I cut my nails was in 2008. I cut them half off. Prior to that was in 2007 when I cut them completely off, which was like another transition time in my life, such as this. So that there are no misunderstandings or misconceptions, I am not cutting my nails because I can't do anything with them. Okay, for me to have grown my nails this long, this has been 5 years. Please understand that if I can grow my nails this long, myself and all the other nail girls, then we do have the propensity to adapt and do things with our nails. And it doesn't make us nasty. I don't keep anything under my nails. There's nothing under my nails. My nails stay clean. My nails could possibly be, I won't say that because somebody will take it out of context. They're not the absolute cleanest, but I keep my nails very clean. So it's very ignorant and asinine when you just assume that we're nasty because we can do something that you can't. Also, before I chop these things off, because I may not get this question until I do allow them to grow again, but please understand this. When you take it upon yourself to come out your mouth to ask us, how do you wipe? Okay, listen, we all think things from time to time. We all got things going on in our mind, but that does not mean that we have to say the things that we think to display ignorance, because that is the most ignorant, disrespectful, asinine question that you can ask of a person. If you meet somebody and they don't have hands, do you ask them how do they wipe? I was watching a show just recently with this man who had absolutely no arms and he did everything with his feet. Would you come out and tell him, ill, you couldn't cook for me, ill, you so nasty? No, you wouldn't. So please stop disrespecting us like we are freaks of nature, because we are not. We are human beings who have feelings just like you do. Okay, so now that we're done, one of the reasons I've decided to cut my nails is because I have a special person in my life that I care very deeply about, and she mentioned a couple of things to me about my nails that truly gave me pause, made me think. But what she said to me was that there were a lot of beautiful things about me, but they tend to be overlooked because of the distraction caused by my nails. She said that she feels like I hide behind my nails, and there could be some truth to that. I won't dispute it. I don't know. I haven't totally figured myself out psychologically yet, but it did really make me think. She said that people know me by my nails, and that's cool. It's all good, especially hometown people. If you mention my name or whatever, if you say the girl with the long nails, most of them definitely know what you're referring to. But it made me think, is if that was something that I wanted, do I want to be known solely for my nails? So that made me think. Also, another thing that she said was that she feels that there are things attached to my nails, things, situations, people, feelings, emotions. And I can definitely go with that, because it makes me think about those that cut their locks ceremonially, like things are attached to them And I have experienced a lot of things in probably just the past year alone that could have taken devastating or detrimental tolls on my mind, my body, spiritually. But by the grace of God, it didn't. So, you know, it just made me really think if now wasn't the time to start shedding some things. I have always considered myself to be vocal when it comes to what I believe, whether it's on Facebook or any venue. So it's no secret that I believe in God. I am that person that believes that if I delight myself in my divine Father, that He will give me the desires of my heart. And there were specific things that I asked for, seven specific things that I asked for. And He, once I submitted, completely submitted and said, okay, I will follow and move in accordance to your will. He gave me the things that I asked for. I asked to be able to go to Georgia to visit my sister. Thank you, Tico, because you really got it popping for my birthday. I asked to have extra money to be able to travel, to be able to handle business I had to take care of in Jersey to see family and friends. I asked to be out of my apartment and out of Robinson County for my birthday. My birthday was July 14th. I turned 40, 40 strong, baby. And if anybody knows me, they know that I very rarely leave my apartment. I am not a person who associates a lot. I don't have a lot of company. I don't talk a lot on the phone. Most times you have to catch me on Facebook. But I am a person who likes to move whenever I want to move. And with school and everything that's been going on, I haven't had that opportunity. So I asked to please be able to be out of my apartment and gone for my birthday. And I was in B-more, baby, with my family and my grandmother when I turned 40. So that was an awesome blessing. I asked again to be able to see my family and friends. That's something I haven't been able to do since I left Jersey in like almost 4 years. I asked to be able to have time, energy, and finances to be able to do something with my kids, and He allowed that as well. And for 4 years, I have been dying to get down to the beach, and I finally got a chance to do it. I didn't care if it was just to go out there for a moment, look around, walk on the beach. It's just that I love the water. I love being near the beach, and I haven't gone in so long that I just wanted the opportunity to do that. And yes, He blessed me with that too. Those were the specific things that I asked for, but He gave me like, what, three major bonuses. The first major bonus was romance, something that I truly was not expecting, but I'll take it and I'll go with it. Number two, my oldest daughter's tuition, unexpectedly, completely paid for, okay? Another huge blessing. Number three, my beautiful, gorgeous angel of a grandbaby. Yes, I said it. I am a glam mother. Not a grandmother, glam mother. Let's get it straight and not get it twisted. I am not ready to embrace the grand yet. Okay. Those who know me and know my story know that I am an incest survivor. It is not something that I am ashamed about. I've been in recovery now for 7 years. My father was my predator. I was raped, molested, and abused at the age of 13. It just so happened that for whatever reason, it was meant to happen, who knows, but my daughter suffered the same demise, and out of it comes my beautiful grandbaby. And it's crazy because the situations are so parallel. It happened to me when I was 13. It happened with her when she was 13. The man that assaulted her was the same age as my father. It happened with her 26 years after it happened with me, which is 2 times 13. She had the baby on my father's birthday, which was 1/13/13. So I'm trying to understand the relevance in all these ones and threes and 13s or whatever is flying around. But who knows? I guess we'll see that later. But yes, that is my biggest major bonus that I am now able and and ready to share with the world, something we weren't able to do before because we weren't really sure what was going on with everything, because it is a legal matter that has to be handled. But I also want my daughter to be proud of who she is. I do not want her to hold her head low and be ashamed. I am not ashamed of her or my grandbaby. It is a situation that happened that did not have anything to do with her. And for those who are wondering why she put her business out there, wonder that when I've already helped somebody that's close to you or somebody in your family, because this is something that we absolutely choose not to speak about. And when we don't, we do nothing but protect the predator so that he can go out, or he or she can go out and violate someone else. And whenever a child, a person, a woman, man, whatever is violated, you might as well put a gun to their heads and kill them, because you are basically taking their lives. Yes, I know from first experience. So, with all that being said, I do know that God has given me a lot of room to chill. I have had a lot of things going on, but he has given me a peace of mind. He's kept me stationary. But I feel like right now he's saying to me that I have some things for you to do, and it's time for you to move. It's time for you to make some moves in his order. And my nails just aren't allowed on this trip, but it's all good. It's okay. It's okay. But I want to say this. There are a lot of you MFs and SOBs that have pissed me off to the point where I want to grow them as long as I can, because you're so ignorant and so just so mean, just for no reason, that you make me challenge myself to want to go as far as I can just to show you what I can do. But what I will not do is let you guys be above the God that I serve. So yes, this is something that I have to do. Okay, I think we're somewhat clear as to why I've decided to cut my nails. I've been contemplating this for a while. This is never easy for me. And a little later on, when you actually see me cut them, it is a possibility. I may not, but just in case, it is a possibility that I may get a little sentimental, a little teary, because this is always hard for me. But I'm going to tell you what just really said, you know what, it's time. When I went and made my last stop up north when I was in New York, and I broke a freaking nail in two. I don't know how, but I ended up breaking the middle finger in two. I found one piece, couldn't find the other, so I glued the first piece on. I had to leave the other one there. Frustrated me to no end. I always need to have my nails with me. If I break one and can't find it, I feel like I'm losing a piece of myself. Okay, fast forward. I get all the way back down south, and I make it down to South Carolina, my last stop, last part of my little trip. And man, I'm at the beach with the kids and we're having fun and playing in the water and everything. And then once we're done, I come back up and I'm trying to get the sand off. And I just happen to look up and I broke another nail, lost it somewhere on the beach. I was frantic, but then I was like, you know what? That's it. It's time. Sitting on that beach and realizing that God had yet again given me at least two things in my face just that day that I had asked for. I felt like I had come full circle. I was sitting there with my grandbaby. I had just turned 40, and my life, you know, going through my recovery, I have transitioned at least twice, but I am so blessed and thankful and humble for where I am now. And I, like I said, it felt like I come full circle, and it was like, it's time, you know. Guess what, guys? They'll grow back once I cut them. I'm just going to tip them anyway. So, you know, today, this is my way. This is my way of showing reverence to my Divine Father for the transformation and the transition that I'm making in him and through him, and my acknowledgement and acceptance of the ordination of the life that he has ordained for me, and my willingness to move in his order, in his will. So for those who have loved me and supported me and supported my passion to grow my nails and have fanned me and followed me, I so appreciate you. I love you all. I have talked with so many people across the seas, all over the country, and you have never given me anything but respect. I have had to put a few of you guys in your place. I had to check a few people, but it's all good. I don't mind doing that because I still got you here. I love you guys so much. Thank you. Thank you for everything. And for those of you guys, yeah, for those of you who hated on me, who ridiculed me, and chose to be nothing but rude, mean, and disrespectful for no other reason, and for the same no other reason that you choose to do it to the other nail girls, you know what? I push up one for you, too. How about I push up two? The two that I broke in commemoration, okay? You don't get that here, baby. You don't get that. I don't care what nobody thinks about me, from the Pope to the pulpit. So even after watching this video, whether you know me or not, I don't care about what you think about me. You could say whatever you want to say, do whatever you want to do. It matters me none. You don't carry me. You do nothing for me. Okay. As my friend would say, you don't F me, feed me, or finance me, and you do not take care of my children. You don't keep a roof over my head. And you don't put clothes on my back. You do nothing for me. So if you can't support me and love me, be gone. I don't need you. Okay? But for everybody else, thank you. Thank you so much. And I still hope that you will still be my friend just because I don't have these. Okay? They'll be back maybe another 5 years, but they'll be back. But for right now, they got to go bye-bye. So say bye-bye. The next time you see them, I will be chopping them off. Stay tuned because I will let you join in on that. I love you guys. Thank you so much for everything. I love you. Just give me the sunshine with your smile. I'll be okay. No matter if the rain falls, when you call, I'll be okay. Just give me the sunshine with your smile. No matter if the rain falls, when you call, I'll be okay. Oh, it's gonna be alright. I know it's gonna be okay. It's gonna be alright with you. I know I'll be okay. It's gonna be alright. I know it's gonna be okay. It's gonna be alright with you. I know I'll be okay. Okay, FB fam, you ready? Here we go. I'm gonna try it. It's been so long since I've cut my nails. I don't even know if these little nippers are gonna work. But as I said before, I don't take this lightly. Like I said earlier, I do have a friend, a special friend that mentioned some things to me, and she did mention the fact that maybe there were some things attached to my nails, feelings, emotions, situations, people, places, things, I guess, all of that, that anything that's tied to me emotionally, physically, mentally. So, you know, I can definitely go with that. So in light of shedding some things, negative, all negative things, I try to be a very positive person. I don't like negative things. I don't like negative people. I don't like negative auras. So I want to expel all the negative energy that I have in and around me so I can move forward positively. Okay. So what I've done is I've comprised a list of 10 things, 10 things I consider negative, or 10 things that I feel like might have been holding me back or whatever. And I'm going to cut each nail, depending upon that factor or that facet or whatever. And which nail I cut is going to be dependent upon the severity of that particular aspect or how it has affected me or whatever. Okay, so here we go. The first one is going to be releasing any and all concepts of what people think about me. As I stated before, I could care less what anybody thinks about me, from the Pope to the pulpit. How about we go ahead and cut one of the longest ones just to commemorate that? Let's go with this one. I'm not ready to cut the other one yet. Let's try it. Let's go. Okay. There it go. Ah, it went flying. Oh my God. I wish I had my friend Willie. Willie was with me when I cut him last time. Look at that. Oh my God. Okay, I really can't believe I'm doing this. Okay, the second one I'm going to cut is removing any insecurities that I may have had. I've had a lot of them over the years. Some of them have been expelled through my recovery, but they're not always that easy to get away from and walk away from. So how about I cut this one to solidify getting rid of those insecurities? Oh, in the name. There it go. Oh! Okay. All right, the third one is removing any anger or resentment that I may have that could be stifling me and holding me back from going forward. Let's move over to this hand. I'm getting kind of freaked out over here. Okay, let's go with this one. This one is for any anger or resentment that I could be harboring and holding me back. All right? Oh, jeez. Okay. Oh, my God. Okay. Okay. One, two, three. I wasn't sure how many I was missing. Hold on.
Okay. We're at three now. All right. Okay. Number four. Fears. Okay. Let's go with any fears. Let's cut this one for fears. Okay. Any fears I may have been harboring that could possibly be holding me back from moving in the will of God. Here we go.
There you go. Okay. Procrastination, one of my biggest things, and I have gotten better. It has really gotten a lot better. So how about we cut, and it is really, really bad for me too. Oh God. Still got my A though, you know, still got my I have a 4.0. I'm just a little less than a 4.0, but I'm still up there. So let's cut one for the spirit of procrastination. Ah, yeah, let's go with this one. Oh my goodness. Here we go. Ah. Okay, so now, oh God, I'm freaking out, guys. Believe it or not, I'm really freaking out right now. Okay, the next thing I want to shake is any anger, resentment, worries, insecurities that I might have right now regarding the two situations with my two babies, my two daughters, Tracy and Keitra. I want to release any of those things right now that could keep me going forward and doing what I need to do for my babies. So wow, let's go with this is one of the longest ones, so we're gonna go with this one. Releasing the anger and resentment and worries and insecurities that could be surrounding the situations for both my daughters, Tracy and Keitra. Maybe that one I don't want to cut. I don't want to break. There it go. There it go. Wow. Okay. The next thing I want to let go of is any how can I say this? I want to let go of toxic relationships. I have 1, 2, 3, 4 left. I want to let go of toxic relationships, and that is extremely detrimental for me and my life. I have a tendency to hold on just because I love the way that I do, and I always figure that everybody deserves so much love, so it's hard for me sometimes to let go even when it's toxic. So what I want to do is I want to release that. Yeah. To love. Let's go. Toxic relationships. This is like one of my
longest ones. See.
Ooh.
Oh.
Okay. Okay, I'm going to cut this one to release any anger and resentment that I may have carried from my failed marriage. I don't even know what to say with other than that. I don't want to harbor any type of negative feelings in any form or fashion for anything that could have been, would have been, should be. So we're going to cut this one for that. Yeah. How about we do that? This is crazy, right? Mm. There you go. All right. I have two nails left. I left these two for a reason. A particular reason. As I stated before, I am an incest survivor. This finger right here is reserved for my predator. It is reserved for my father. I am going to release anything that may have been any residual effects that have not been expelled in my recovery. Okay, so I'm gonna push up this one, release on this one for my dad, my predator. This is for the most ultimate toxic relationship in my life. Lasted 12, 13 years to end in a way to realize that you loved and genuinely cared for somebody who you never really knew. I have a tendency to love people in hopes that they will love me the same in return. And it's not always like that. And it's okay. I've learned that. I also learned that a lot of my blessings and a lot of other things were tied to me not being ready to let go of a toxic relationship, a toxic situation. And once I was ready to submit and ready to let go and let God do what He had intended, then blessings continue to flow even more than they had before. What I had begun to realize is that God was telling me, I want to completely sever your ties and separate you from this relationship when your little heart wants to allow you to hold on. And I don't want you to hold on, not even a little bit, because I need to take you places where this particular relationship is not supposed to go. I get that now. So I'm going to release on these two fingers the two most impactful, detrimental relationships, toxic relationships that resonated in my mind, my body, and my spirit. Okay, you see this smile? This smile is for a reason, because I have grown and I have matured. I have been set free. I have become liberated in my recovery, in God and in my recovery, nothing else. So this is it. These are the last two. Dad, this is for you. Bambi, this is for you. I push up both of these for you. And as of right now, I release. I absolutely, just to make sure we do it right, how about we take this off? Okay, baby. Bye, baby. Bye-bye. Ah. Ah. Goodbye. It is done. It is said and it is done. I have absolutely, positively, I've done it, people, 5 years, Here it is. For those who said, no, you're not. No, you're not. For those who said, those aren't yours. Those aren't yours. Here you go. Here you go. Here they are. Here they are. Bye-bye. Say bye-bye. Listen, for all my fans, I love you. I adore you. You have been, oh God, you have given me life on so many different occasions. Just to smile, just to tell me you're so beautiful. You're so, and I really do appreciate that, guys, because when I look in the mirror, I see somebody who's and I'm okay with that. But I just want to thank you. Don't forget, listen, I cut them today. I'm tipping them tonight. And as of tomorrow, they start to grow back. So they'll be back. It might be another 5 years, but they'll be back, okay? Listen, I am ever, ever evolving into me in the newness of God, okay? And I hope that somewhere in your spirit, I have encouraged you, inspired you, and motivated to do the same, okay? Grow into you. Through your divine, for whatever that means for you. I have friends all over the place, friends from different denominations, some who believe, some who don't believe, and that's okay. Whatever keeps you moral and sane every day and keeps you in a place where you can respect me and respect others, then I'm all for it. I love you guys. Thank you so much for sharing with me. Okay, listen, I will be back. The next part you will see will be after I have actually tipped them again, designed them myself, okay? And you'll see where we'll start this process all over again. Thank you so much, guys, for being with me. I love you. I love you to pieces. I'll see you in a few with the new.
There were times that I was afraid, wanted you to leave, but you stayed right here by my side. You never let me go, you always stayed around. You stayed around. And it doesn't matter, no. You know, you and me, we gonna stay together. Baby, we've been through so much. Our love is so strong. You and me stay together. We know each other so well. We always seem to tell when I need a little kissing and hugging and a special kind of loving. You love me like a champion. Yeah. Baby, you're my superman. Yeah, 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 yeah.
You know I love you, right?
Love you too.
Ain't nobody got what we got.
No, no. Wanna be with my baby.
Yes. It's head built from the concrete, baby. Don't get no better than this.
Some ups and downs, made a lot of bad mistakes, but we've always had some good times, and through it all, you held me down, baby, you've always held it down, oh yeah.
There were times when I was afraid and wanted you to leave, but you stayed right here by my side. You never let me go.